Anything to warm me.
All right, thanks for joining me today for our seated core stability workout. I'm just going to get ahead and sit in my chair. We're gonna just start with a nice dynamic warm up. So I'm just gonna sit tall in my chair. First thing we're gonna do is just do a little bit of deep breathing to relax our body. Sitting up tall, having your spine elongated, you can have your hands on your knees or on the chair, whatever feels good, just sitting up tall. And let's just take a few deep breaths. I'm going to do about three of them. Inhale as much as you can. Feel your shoulders lift up towards the ceiling. And then exhale. Let your shoulders lower. Just doing it at your own speed. Kind of just preparing your body for our workout today. And also relaxing a little bit. I am going to turn on some background music. Let me know if it's too loud, too quiet. For our workout today, we are going to be doing it in a flow style. So if you have any questions as I'm going, just shout them out and I'll explain something again. Let's move into a little bit of core activation here. So still sitting up tall, we're going to bring our belly button in towards our spine. So when you bring your belly button in towards your spine, you're kind of just like pushing your hips back a little bit, sucking that belly button in towards your spine, and you should feel your core activate as you do that. I'm just gonna do it and hold it for about 2 to 3 seconds and then relax. I'm gonna do that about 5 or so times. Really just starting to engage those core muscles so you can feel where we are working today. And just taking your time with this, holding it for a few seconds once you're bringing that belly button in, and then relax and let come back out. Once you have done that a few times, still sitting up straight, we're gonna move into some inhale and exhaling, kind of deep breathing again, but this time we're gonna add in some arm swings. I'm still sitting up tall in my chair, I'm gonna have my arms down at my sides, fingertips pointing towards the ground. As I inhale, I'm gonna just move my arms back behind me, keeping my elbows straight, taking that inhale, feeling my chest kind of puff forward. And then as I exhale, sweeping my arms out in front of me. And just go through that a few times, moving your arms, feeling that stretch in your chest and in your shoulders, but also just focusing on taking some deep breaths. Going at our own speed here again, probably do 5 to 10 of these. Awesome. Once you're feeling good with that inhale, exhale, arm swings, I like to just shake out my arms, let them fall down at my side. Still sitting up tall, we're gonna move into some heel lifts. So I'm gonna bring my feet like one step forward in my chair. If it works for you to scooch forward so you can sit up tall, and have some more space at your feet. Right now, my feet are shoulder width apart. I'm just gonna raise one heel up at a time and then lower that heel back to the ground and alternate. You kind of feel my ankles stretching out here. Maybe you feel some pops, but we're just gonna alternate heel lifts 1 foot at a time to just engage our calves, our ankles, and our lower legs. Awesome. Once you're feeling good with those heel lifts, let's move into some shoulder squeezes. Gonna bring my feet a little bit closer to me. I'm gonna put my arms into a like goalpost position with my elbows bent and my fingertips towards the ceiling. From here, once you are in that position with your goalpost arms, I'm just going to squeeze my shoulder blades together. Feeling my chest puff out forward and feeling that squeeze at the back. And then I'm coming back to neutral. Just gonna do this again 5 to 10 times. Really just waking up our chest, our shoulders. Awesome. Last one here. Again, when you're feeling good with those shoulder squeezes, gonna let my arms fall down at my side. From here, I'm gonna move into a neck stretch. Gonna have my hands on my knees, or you can have them on the arms of your chair. Let your shoulders go very neutral. So just relax your shoulders, sitting up tall. From here, I'm gonna bring my right ear down towards my right shoulder. Again, not trying to bring your shoulder up to your ear, just bringing your ear down to your shoulder so you feel that stretch along the left side of your neck. And just holding it here for a few seconds. And then when you're ready, I'm gonna switch, bringing my left ear this time down towards my left shoulder. Taking a few deep breaths as well. From here, I am going to bring my head back up to neutral. This time, I'm going to bring my chin to my chest and point my nose down towards the floor. So I'm getting that stretch this time in the back of my neck, into my shoulder blades. I feel the taller I sit up straight here, the more I feel this in the back of my neck and into my shoulders. And then the last one here, bringing my head to neutral. Gonna finish with bringing my nose up towards the ceiling, kind of letting my neck fall back onto my shoulders, and then stretching that front part of your neck into your chest. Don't have to extend your head super high towards the ceiling for this one, just as much range of motion as you have to feel that stretch at the front of your neck. And then when you're ready, bring your head back up to neutral. Let's finish here with some seated cat-cow. I'm gonna scooch back in my chair just a little bit, and I'm gonna hold on to the arms of my chair. From here, same thing as we're doing cat-cow on the ground. I'm gonna bring my belly button in towards my spine, lean forward a little bit, and really feel that curl of my back, really arching out towards the back of the chair. And then from here, bringing my belly button down towards my legs, arching my spine the opposite way this time, and just moving through this at your own speed. Really feeling that stretch in your back and also in your core. Once you're feeling good with that, we are going to move into our flow for the day. I'm gonna grab a quick sip of water. Like I said before, we're gonna move through this flow style. We'll hold each about 30 seconds or equivalent to that in reps. So if you need me to slow down or have any questions, just shout them out, but let's get started. The goal for today is to really activate our core. So just like we did in that warm up, sitting up tall, bringing that belly button in towards your spine, and having that good posture, your hips are stacked right underneath your shoulders, is really gonna activate that core the most. If you need to take breaks at any time, feel free to do so, listen to your body. But let's start with some knee lifts. We're gonna start with one knee at a time. You can have your hands on the arms of the chair for support, or you can have your hands down at your side, really wherever. I'm just gonna start by lifting one knee up at a time towards my chest. And as you're lifting that knee up, I'm starting with my right knee. My foot is hovering over the ground, and I'm gonna hold it here for about 2 to 3 seconds before I switch. So the longer you're holding that knee up, the more you're feeling that engage in your core, and then very slowly letting that foot come back towards the ground and alternating on the other side. So this movement, definitely slow and steady is what we're looking for here, and just alternating knee lifts from left to right. Taking your time here, having that posture nice and tall. We'll go for about 10 more seconds, alternating knee lifts. And in 3, 2, 1, and relax. Bring both those feet back down towards the ground. From here, we are going to bring both knees up this time at the same time, adding a little bit of a challenge here. If bringing both knees up today is not feeling good for you, you can continue to do one at a time. This time, I'm going to hold on to the arms of my chair and just lean back slightly to brace my upper body. From here, I'm bringing both of my feet flat on the ground, about shoulder width apart. From here, raising both of my knees up towards my chest, holding it again 2 to 3 seconds, and then lowering those feet back towards the ground. Let's try to do about 10 of these. Again, at your own speed, holding both of those knees up towards your chest and then lowering back to the ground. Really engaging your core here, especially those lower abs, as you're bringing those knees up and then lowering them back down, taking deep breaths as you're going. And again, doing about 10 of them at your own speed. Nice job here. I have 3 more. Continue to push through here, taking your time. You really want to have resistance as you're lowering your legs back down. That's going to be the toughest part here. So if you're taking your time lowering those feet back down, you're going to feel the most engaging in your core. Last one, bringing those knees up and lowering back down. Nice job there. 10 knee lifts about. Take a moment here, let your feet come back onto the ground. Take some deep breaths, grab some water if you need. Our third little movement for our knee lift sequence. This time we're gonna do a resisted knee lift and we're gonna go one leg at a time. So I am gonna start by putting both of my hands flat on my quads near my knees. For the resisted knee lift, we're gonna do one leg at a time. I'm gonna start with my right leg. So with my right hand and my right arm, I'm gonna apply pressure down towards the floor on that right knee as I'm trying to lift that knee up off the ground. So you're creating resistance with your own force and still lifting that knee up towards your chest. This is just adding a little bit, again, resistance, takes a little bit more core strength, and then you can control the resistance that you're putting on your leg. We're gonna do about 10 of these on our right leg, and then we'll switch 10 on our left leg. So when you're ready, if you're not already, go ahead, adding that resistance into that knee lift. Still sitting up tall, taking some deep breaths. And again, don't have to add the resistance here if you don't want to. I got one more on my right side. Awesome. After you've done about 10 on the right, I'm gonna switch to the left. Same thing, having my left hand on my left quad near my knee, applying that pressure down towards the floor as I'm trying to lift that knee up towards my chest. If you're not feeling this in your core, think about engaging and bringing that belly button in towards your spine, maybe sitting up a little bit taller. Awesome job here. I got a couple more. And last one. Awesome. That was about 20 knee lifts total for that sequence. I'm going to grab a little bit of water. And we are going to start from the beginning. Those 3 knee sequences, we're going to do them one more time. Maybe a little quicker this time because I can talk a little bit less. But we're going to start with no resistance, single knee lifts, one leg at a time. I'm going to start with my right leg. Again, doing about 5 to 10 of these, just depending on what feels best for you. When you're ready, go ahead, sitting up tall, bringing that belly button into spine. I'm starting with my right leg, just knee lifts. Awesome job. After about 5 to 10 on your right leg, I'm gonna switch to my left leg. Taking some deep breaths as you're lifting that knee up. It's easy to sometimes hold your breath here, but being consistent about your breathing will make these movements even a little bit easier. Awesome. Once you've done about 10 on your left leg, take a moment to recover here. We are going to move now to our second little knee exercise. Knee lifts with both legs this time. So I'm going to brace my upper body by holding on to the arms of my chair. Scoot forward a little bit into my seat so I can lean back just a tiny bit. And when you're ready, bringing both knees at the same time up towards your chest, keeping those feet hovering above the floor. You can have your knees together. You can have your feet together if that's helpful. But again, 5 to 10 of these. Taking your time as you're lowering those feet to the ground. Awesome job. Last few. Awesome. Last one here. Awesome job. Once you're lowering both your feet back down to the ground, excuse me, take a moment to recover here. We're going to finish this knee lift sequence with our resisted knee lifts on both legs. Sitting up tall, putting both of your hands, palms down on your quads by your knee. We're going to go one leg at a time here. About 5 to 10 of these resisted knee lifts, adding that pressure down towards the floor as you're bringing that knee up towards your chest. Working on that right leg right now. Controlling the pressure that you're adding. Feeling that core engage. And switching. Final 5 to 10 on your left leg. Awesome job. Last couple here. And in 3, 2, 1, and finish. Let your legs lower down. Take a moment to recover. You can stretch those legs out long and grab a little bit of water. Awesome job. We are gonna move right along to our next exercise. We have a seated core twist. I'm going to plant my feet flat on the ground in front of me, about hip width apart. From here, I'm going to bring my hands either, you can have them together in front of your chest, palms together. You can have them at your side, hands on your hips, whatever really works best for your hand placement. From here, I'm going to turn my hips and my chest towards the wall to my right while keeping my feet planted on the ground. As you are turning your hips and your chest to face the wall to the right, hold that position for a few seconds, and then we're gonna go back to the beginning and alternate on the left side. So a seated core twist. As you're turning, holding that core twist at either side for a few seconds, still sitting up tall, bringing that belly button in towards your spine, and taking deep breaths as you move through this. We're gonna go here for about 20 more seconds with our seated core twist. Really wanna keep those feet planted and just focus on moving your hips and your chest at the same time. And in 3, 2, 1, bringing your body back to neutral and letting yourself recover for a moment. We are gonna add on to this core twist by bringing in a high knee core twist. So a little bit different. I'm going to start with my elbows wide. You can have your hands behind your head. You can have them on your shoulders, whatever position feels best for you so that your elbows are pointed out either to the right or to the left. I'm going to be sitting up tall here. This time for our core twist, I'm going to shimmy to sit kind of at the front of my chair so I have more space for my legs. From here, I'm going to core twist, bringing opposite knee to opposite elbow. So raising my left knee up off the ground and then twisting my core to bring my right elbow to touch my left knee or to get as close as you can. And then we're just gonna alternate from left to right. If bringing your elbow to your knee is not feeling great for you today, you can lower your elbows and just use your hands. So touch opposite hand to opposite knee. You're still getting that core twist in, just a little bit less impact or a little bit less movement here. Whatever works for you, let's continue with these high knee core twists for about 20 more seconds. Again, you can go at your own speed for this one. You can take it quick, or you can take it slow and controlled. Both of them are engaging that core. Nice job here, last 10 seconds. And in 3, 2, 1, and rest. Let your feet fall, or come back down to the ground. Let your arms fall and take a moment to recover. I'm gonna grab a sip of water. We're gonna do that little core twist sequence one more time. Starting at the top with our seated core twist, having our feet planted, having your hands in front of your chest or wherever works best for you. We'll go 30 seconds of seated core twist, just turning those hips and chest to face right and left. Taking your time on these, again, the longer you're holding that engaged position, the more you're gonna feel it in your core. So just take your time. Excuse me. Awesome job. Let's go 15 more seconds here with this seated core twist. And in 3, 2, 1, awesome job. Let's move right into high knee core twist. Minimal break if possible. This time bringing my elbows up, hands behind my head, opposite knee to opposite elbow here. We'll go 30 seconds, high knee core twist. Awesome job, way to keep moving here. We'll go 15 more seconds. Breathing through, last 10. And in 3, 2, 1, and rest. Plant your feet, let your arms fall down at your side. Awesome job there. Take a deep breath, grab some water if you need. We are gonna move this time on to our next exercise. Next one we have our leg marches with our hands in the air. So at the beginning, we kind of were doing our knee lifts. This time we're gonna add a little bit of a challenge if you would like. I'm gonna start sitting up tall, feet planted on the ground. This time I'm gonna raise both of my hands in the air, fingertips towards the ceiling. This is elongating our spine, stretching out our core, kind of forcing you to sit up as tall as you can and reach as tall as you can. From here, we are just going to do a knee lift, alternating right and left. We'll go for about 30 seconds. When you're ready, go ahead, bringing one knee up at a time towards your chest or marching in place. Holding those hands up in the air, elbows straight. If you do need to take a break, you can lower those hands down. Again, just an added challenge here as we're doing these leg lifts. Nice job, everyone. Halfway. And in 3, 2, 1, and rest. Let those arms fall down at your side. We're gonna do that one more time. Taking a moment to rest here, recover, grab a sip of water. One more time here with our leg marches with our hands in the air. When you're ready, bringing those hands back up towards the ceiling as tall as you can, reaching as tall, really elongating your spine. And when you're ready, last 30 seconds here of these leg marches slash knee lifts. One at a time. If you're not feeling it in your core, remember to bring that belly button in towards your spine. You can create that core engagement even if you're not exactly feeling it just by moving a little bit differently. And in 3, 2, 1, and release. Let your arms fall down and take a moment to recover. Nice job. We are going to move into our next little sequence here with some leg lifts. So we've been doing knee lifts. This time we are going to straighten our legs. This is going to create a little bit more resistance, a little bit more of a challenge. So if you prefer doing the knee lifts, totally fine. If you would like to try leg lifts, we are going to do that now. So I'm going to sit, you can sit maybe a little bit further back for this one. The further back you're sitting in your chair, the more of like your hamstring is going to be on the back of that chair. So it might be a little bit easier to do a leg lift the farther you're sitting back. So play around with where you're sitting and what feels best for you. It's going to be different for everybody. We're going to start with one leg at a time. So we're just going to go 30 seconds of our right leg. I'm going to have my left knee still bent. My right leg right now is straight. I'm holding onto the arms of my chair for support, or you can have your arms down at your side, but we're just going to lift that right leg straight in the air, keeping our knee straight. My toes are pointed towards the ceiling. When you're ready, we will go in 3, 2, 1, 30 seconds of just this right leg lift. Taking your time, I sometimes find myself curling my back, curling my spine, and leaning forward a little bit. Make sure we're sitting up straight. That's going to get us the best core engagement. Sometimes it helps me when I'm sitting up straight to have my hands on my hips so I can feel my body if it's curling backwards and correct that. Last 10 seconds here. Great job. Way to keep moving through. In 3, 2, 1, and rest. Lower that right leg down. Take a moment to recover. Nice job there. That one's, feel it in your core. Also felt it in my quads a little bit. Nice job. We are gonna do the opposite now. We're gonna do our left leg. When you're ready, extending that left leg out straight. My right knee is bent. Again, find a good position that works for you. Sitting up tall, engaging that core. And in 3, 2, 1, let's go ahead. Left leg lift. Trying to keep that knee straight, toes pointed towards the ceiling. Taking your time here. Speed does not matter as long as you're just moving and having good form here. Last 15. And in 3, 2, 1, and rest. Sitting up tall, taking a few deep breaths. Nice job. Next, we are gonna add even more of a challenge to this one. This time we're gonna try to do leg lifts with both our legs together. So instead of lifting one in the air at a time, we're gonna try to lift both in the air. Again, like I said before, find a good position on that chair that best supports you in this movement. You can sit back a little bit further. If doing both legs doesn't feel great, you can continue with one leg at a time. We'll go 30 seconds, leg lifts. I'm having my feet together, toes pointed in the air, knees are straight. And when you're ready, in 3, 2, 1, go ahead, 30 seconds, straight leg lifts, legs together. Definitely a little bit more challenging here. Take your time. Really focusing on lowering those legs down. The slower you lower your legs down, the more resistance you have and the more core muscles you're using here. Last 10 seconds. Great job. 3, 2, 1, and release. Let your legs come back down. Find a position to rest in for a moment. Nice job. We are gonna go through that cycle. Excuse me, one last time. We'll do single leg lifts right into the double leg lift. We'll go a little bit quicker. Excuse me. All right, starting at the top, we'll start with our right leg. We're just gonna go through all three really quickly. We'll do 15 seconds of our right leg, 15 seconds of our left leg, and then 30 seconds of legs together. Take breaks if you need. just a little bit of a challenge here. So when we're ready, starting with that right leg out straight, left knee is bent. In 3, 2, 1, go ahead, 15 seconds, right leg lift. Sitting up tall, taking some deep breaths. Nice job here. And in 3, 2, 1, and switch right into that left leg lift. Awesome job. And in 3, 2, 1, last 30 seconds here, moving into that double leg lift, feet together, lifting both legs at a time to finish it out here. Way to push through. Feeling that burn in your core. Halfway, last 15. Nice job. And in 3, 2, 1, and rest. Woo, nice work there. Take this moment to recover a little bit. Shake your legs out, grab some water. Awesome job.
Every time we do the double leg lifts, it reminds me of the episode in An Officer and a Gentleman when they're trying to get him to DOR, drop on request, with Louis Gossett Jr.
I don't think I've seen that.
Oh, wow. Okay. Now you need to.
I know. Awesome. We are crushing it. We're going to move into our next exercise. We're going to do some calf raises. So we're going to focus a little bit on our lower legs right now, while still engaging our core and moving our legs. So sitting up tall in your chair, feet planted flat on the ground. I'm kind of sitting towards the edge of my seat just because it makes it easier for me to move my legs. But we're going to start with calf raises, 1 foot at a time. So I'm going to start with my right leg. You can add resistance to these just like we were doing before with our knee lifts. So if you want to add resistance to your calf raises, hands on your quads, pushing down, creating a little bit more of that resistance in your leg as you're moving. Let's do 10 on each leg, starting with our right leg. I'm going to move my feet actually a little bit closer to my body, closer to the chair, instead of a little bit further out from me. Whatever feels better for you. And I'm going to switch, going to my left leg. 10 calf raises here. Awesome job. Once you are done with both calf raises on either leg, we're going to move into calf raises. This time we're going to bring our heels together and have our toes pointed outward. So my heels are together, my right toes are pointed out towards the right, and my left toes are pointed out towards the left. Sitting up tall in your chair here, we're going to do 10 of these with our heels together, toes separated. So raising those heels off the ground, both at the same time, and then lowering them back to the floor. Awesome job here. Still sitting up tall, feeling that core engagement as you're lifting both legs at the same time. And in 3, 2, 1, and rest. Nice job there. We are going to move into, some toe taps, alternating toe taps. This is kind of like a windmill toe touch, but we're going to be seated. I am going to start with my legs extended. So I'm extending my right leg straight out a little bit towards the right, and then extending my left leg out a little bit towards the left. Whatever's comfortable for you, You can have them straight out in front of you, or you can have that little V shape in your legs, whatever feels best. From here, I'm gonna move my hands into that T position, extended on either side. My elbows are straight, right hand's pointed to the wall to my right, left hand's pointed to the wall to my left. From here, we're going to just alternate toe taps. So right hand is gonna come down to touch my left toes, and then my left hand is gonna come down to touch my right toes. After every touch, you wanna come back up to a seated straight up position. That is gonna get you the most core movement here. Instead of just staying bent over and tapping alternating, you wanna come back up to that full seated position every time before you switch. If having your legs extended doesn't feel great, you can keep your knees bent and still do this, just a little bit easier to reach. And instead of touching your toes altogether, you can touch your knees. So still touching opposite knee to opposite hand is still gonna get you that core twist. So we're gonna go here. We've been doing it for a little bit. We'll go about 20 more seconds for this windmill toe touch or alternating toe taps. Bunch of different ways to do it. Whatever feels best for you today. And in 3, 2, 1, coming back up to that seated position, taking a moment to rest. Our next exercise, similar to the toe tap alternating, adding a little bit of a flair to it. We have a kick and twist. So we're gonna keep our arms in that T position. And right now my knees are gonna be bent, feet flat on the ground. This time we're gonna add a leg lift or a kick with that alternating hand to foot touch. So my arms are in that T position. I'm gonna start with my left leg. I'm going to kick my left leg straight out in front of me. So my knees straight, left foot is off the ground. Once I'm in that position, I'm going to do that windmill toe touch, bringing my right hand to touch the top of my left foot, coming back up to center, lowering that foot down, and then repeating on the opposite side. So kicking that right leg out straight, bringing my left hand to touch my right foot, and then alternating back. So it's similar to that windmill toe touch, but we're adding a kick and twist. We're gonna do this for 30 seconds if you haven't started already. If the kick's not feeling great for you, you can just stick with windmill toe touches. But in 3, 2, 1, go ahead, 30 seconds, kick and twist. Kind of adding two movements here. That leg lift, as we know, engages our lower abs, and that twist, we're engaging our obliques and our upper abs here. Making sure that we're coming back to that center position before we switch to really get the most out of our movement. And in 3, 2, 1, and rest. Woo, it's an arm burner too. Letting your hands fall, taking a moment here to recover. Grabbing a quick sip of water. All right, we're gonna do a little challenge, kind of like we've done the last couple times. Let's do 30 seconds of toe taps alternating. So that windmill toe touch right into 30 seconds of the kick and twist. Take breaks if you need, but let's see how we do. Modify any movement that you need to, but we're gonna start at the top with our toe taps alternating, that windmill toe touch with our feet planted. In 3, 2, 1, go ahead, all opposite hand to opposite foot. About 30 seconds here. And take your time, doesn't have to go fast. You're really just focusing on that core movement. Awesome, 15 seconds. And in 3, 2, 1, go ahead. We're going right into that kick and twist. This time, kicking that leg out, still touching opposite hand to opposite foot, but adding that leg lift. Halfway. Last 15 here. Nice job. Way to push through. And in 3, 2, 1, and rest. Woo. Nice job with that one. Gonna take a quick sip of water. Awesome, we have about 15 minutes left in our workout today. We'll finish with some final exercises and then we'll get into a little bit of a cool down. Next up, we have some wood chops. So this is similar to the windmill toe touch, but we're not bending down as far and we're really just focusing on our obliques with the side to side movement that we're gonna do. So for wood chops, I'm gonna stack both of my hands together. So I have my hands in loose fists. I'm gonna stack my hands in the fists on top of each other. You can pretend you're holding an axe, hence the wood chop. But I'm gonna start with both of my hands at my right shoulder, sitting up nice and tall. And then from here, I'm gonna pretend I'm chopping across my body down to my left hip. So we're gonna do 30 seconds of wood chops from your right shoulder to your left hip, really just focusing on those obliques as you're crunching to the side. And when you're ready, we'll go ahead. 3, 2, 1, start wood chops, starting at that right shoulder down to our left hip. Taking your time here, again, you want to get back to that elongated seated position after every time you're chopping across your body. Getting the most range of motion you can here. Last 10 seconds. And 3, 2, 1, and rest. Awesome job. We are going to switch now. Same thing, but we're gonna wood chop from our left shoulder down to our right hip. We'll go 30 seconds here in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, left shoulder to right hip, wood chop. As I'm doing this wood chop, my chest is turning a little bit to face the wall to my right, to face the way that I'm chopping across my body. That's gonna get the most turn in your upper body and really targeting those obliques. Last 10 seconds. And 3, 2, 1, and rest. Nice job there. Gonna take a quick sip of water. We are gonna finish last one or two exercises here with some seated crunches. We're gonna start with just seated crunches forward. So this is kind of similar to our double leg lift, but instead of lifting straight up, we're going to lift our knees in towards our body. So I'm gonna start with my hands on the arms of the chair, my legs extended out straight in front of me. You can have a slight bend in your knees, whatever feels best. Sitting kind of towards the front of your chair, but also having space to lean back a little bit. That's gonna really target these lower abs as we're leaning back from here. And now you can do one leg at a time or you can do both legs at a time. I'm just going to bring both knees in towards my chest, hold that for a second or two, and then extend my legs out straight. We're gonna do 30 seconds of seated crunches. When your legs are extending straight, as a challenge, you can try not to drop your heels down to the floor, but if you do need to rest your heels on the ground as you're extending, that's totally fine. All right, 30 seconds of seated crunches. We'll start in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, 30 seconds here. Extending those legs out straight, bringing your knees into your chest. Taking your time with this one. It is definitely a challenge. Way to push through. Last 15. Nice job here. 10 seconds. And in 3, 2, 1, and release. Woo. Let your legs fall. Take a moment to let your body rest. Nice job there. That one was tricky. This time we're gonna move into some side crunches slash side bends. For this one, we're gonna keep our feet flat on the ground. I'm going to have my arms down at my side, fingertips pointing towards the ground. So I'm sitting kind of forward in my chair so I have some space to move left or right. We are just going to do kind of like a side bend. So I'm gonna start with my right side, bringing my right fingertips down towards the floor as I'm leaning my left side towards the right. And then I'm coming back up to that seated position and then switching on the left. So now I'm bringing my left fingertips down towards the floor and leaning my right shoulder towards the left. So kind of like a seated penguin or a seated side crunch, we're gonna go left to right, alternating here for 30 seconds. So when you're ready, we are gonna start in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, side crunches slash side bends. Again, with this one, the key, every time you come back up to that neutral position, sitting up tall, so you're really getting that full range of motion as you're leaning side to side. Nice job. Last 10. And in 3, 2, 1, and release, coming back to neutral. Excuse me. Nice job, everyone. We are going to finish last challenge of the day. We're going to do 15 seconds of seated crunches into 15 seconds of side crunches, 30 seconds to finish before we get into a cool down today. Whatever feels best for you here in our seated crunches, if you want to do both legs or one leg, totally up to you. But let's get started. Gonna play a little bit more of an upbeat song here to finish. All right, and starting with seated crunches in 3, 2, 1, go ahead, 15 seconds here, seated crunches. Ooh, nice job. And in 3, 2, 1, switching right away to our side crunches. Last 15 seconds. Really finishing, burning out our abs here. And in 3, 2, 1, and release, coming back up to neutral, letting your body recover, taking a few deep breaths. Nice job, everyone.
Anyone who says you can't get a good workout seated has just never done a good seated workout.
I agree. That's right. I'm sweating.
And if the seat doesn't do it, tear it into a foot, do it on a ball, which totally. Is what I'm on. Which I did okay. I only had to hold on for the double leg lifts. I did have to hold on for those. And the ones where you do the reverse crunch at the crunches with the legs. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Those, everything else I was able, I didn't have to hold on to a table.
That's impressive. Nice job.
Whew. Thank you. I'm not cold anymore.
Me either. Let's get into a little cool down. We have a good amount of time to just cool down and stretch a little bit and let our bodies recover. I'm gonna grab a quick sip of water. Let's start with just some deep breathing and stretching towards the ceiling and down towards the ground. Seated forward a little bit in my chair, feet are planted flat in front of me. I'm going to start by taking a nice inhale breath. And as I'm taking that inhale breath, I'm going to reach both hands up towards the ceiling, fingertips towards the sky. If it feels good for you, you can interlace your fingers and turn your palms up towards the ceiling and kind of push your palms forward. That's just going to add some stretch in your fingers and your wrists. That feels good. And then after you're reaching up tall, taking that deep breath, I'm going to release my breath, hinge at my waist, and let my hands come down towards the ground. Do this at your own speed, 3 to 5 times. Really just feeling that reach tall, stretching out all of that core that we just worked on. And then releasing everything as you lean forward. Last one here. Awesome. As you come back up, take your time. Just let your hands fall down at your side. Let your arms go loose. Let's just shake out our arms a little bit. I'm going to start by wiggling my fingers and then rolling my wrists and then kind of just wiggling my shoulders up and down. You can do some shoulder circles if that feels good for you. Do some circles backwards or forwards. And then just let your arms go loose, shake them out. From here, I am going to extend both of my legs straight out in front of me. My feet are together, my toes are pointed towards the ceiling. I'm just going to run my hands kind of down my legs as far as you can go. You can reach your toes, your ankles, just to stretch out the backs of our legs, stretch out our lower back a little bit here, and just reach down as far as feels good for you. Feeling that nice stretch kind of throughout your whole lower half of your body. And when that feels good, just slowly come back up to that seated position. From here, I'm going to extend one leg at a time out to either side. So I'm going to bring my left foot flat on the ground, so my left knee is bent. And I'm going to extend my right leg out towards the right. My right knee is straight. My right toes pointed towards the ceiling. Same thing here, taking both my hands, kind of just running them down my right leg until I get to a point where I'm feeling that really great stretch throughout my right leg and the right side of my body. You can reach your toes, stop at your knee, really whatever feels best. Focusing on that right side, also feeling a little bit of a stretch in like the left side of my back. As I'm reaching towards the right, stretching out those obliques a little bit. When that feels good, coming back to that seated position and then switching. My right foot is planted flat on the ground. My left leg is out straight, running my hands down that left leg. Same thing here. That nice focus stretch on your left side. When that feels good, coming back up to that seated position, let's finish with a few more stretches here, a couple more minutes. This time my feet are flat on the ground. Let's do some seated cat-cow, just like in our warm-up after all of those core exercises. Feels kind of good to stretch out our back and our core. This time I'm going to put my hands on my knees. So I'm sitting up tall, hands are on my knees. I'm bringing my belly button back towards my spine, curving my body in, and my back is kind of extending out towards the chair. Holding this here, you can bring your chin to your chest if that feels good. And then when you're ready, coming out of that position into bringing your belly button forward, feeling your spine curve now in towards your body. So instead of bringing your belly button to spine, you're kind of bringing your spine to your belly button, pushing your chest out forward. Taking your time here with this one, let's just go through a few rounds. really just emphasizing that movement, feeling that really great stretch. And kind of like your midsection. Once you're feeling good with that, I'm going to come back up to a seated position. We'll finish it out here. I'm going to keep my hands on my knees. I'm going to sit up tall. I'm going to push my chest forward just a little bit. So I feel like I'm sitting up tall, pushing my chest forward. My abs are a little bit engaged here. And I'm just going to do a neck stretch to finish out. I'm going to turn my nose to face the wall to my right, while keeping my feet planted forward. My hips and my chest are also facing forward. I'm just turning my head. Once that's feeling good, I'm gonna come back to the center. Now I'm gonna turn my head to the wall to my left. Holding that here for a few moments. Once that's feeling good, coming back to center, this time bringing my nose up towards the ceiling. And then finishing it out, bringing my chin to my chest, nose pointed down towards the ground. Awesome job today, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me for our seated core workout. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and we will see you tomorrow. Thanks, everyone.